I got a new toy. I got a new toy. I got a new toy. And, I don't know. I got a new toy. So anyway, it's an Epiphone Valve Jr. It's a 5-watt. I have seen bigger, but like those come in combos. I don't know how well they are. Oh, yes, I do. The bigger one is a 20 watt. I was considering it, but then I wouldn't be able to get the other things that I wanted to get. And I needed another pedal to replace my reverb. So I got a used Rocktron. It's called a short timer. Retro digital delay. It's freaking nice. I have the digital reverb plugged in, but it's not on. But this is cool because it's an EL84, which later on I'm probably gonna get the 7189 and pop that in, which it's like $34. So I'll get that, and it's military grade, and it's awesome. But and it has a 12AX7 in the preamp. It's single ended, so it's a Class A, and practice amp. And I really expected it not to sound well because I heard from plenty of people that these are hot rod amps. They buy them so they can modify them, and I can't see why yet. You know, the tubes might be different. You know, these might have had their tubes changed out. I haven't checked. I haven't opened it up yet. That says something. That's got to... That has to say something. If I haven't opened it up, if I haven't gotten my hands dirty into it within the first 24 hours, that's saying a lot. It's a little workhorse. God knows how old it is. I think it's like a, I want to say it's like a 2000, maybe a 2005, 2006. I can't remember what the serial numbers were. But they're not that old. But they're great little, they had another one there. I wanted to check it out. $100. $100. Eat your heart out, Shane. I don't know, but it was $100. So got that thrown in the. So now that can, I got rid of my freaking whatchamacallit, the other amp. I'm like, yeah, no. Because this is like total goodness all the time. So that it's a 5-watt amp doesn't mean that it's going to be amazingly loud and clear and, you know, have all, you know, kinds of, yeah, let's take it out. Let's take it out and freaking, you know, and gig in a stadium with it. That ain't happening. But it comes close. It does come close. I mean, you want to mic it up. Reverb, get a pedal. And if you do want some heavier crunch, get an OD glove. And turn down the volume. Turn the volume up on the amp and use the volume on your freaking guitar. Dynamic. I'm very happy. The thing about it is that it's very moddable, which means that you change out some capacitors, you change out some resistors, and it alters the tone and everything like that. There's another tube that I'm thinking of getting. Hopefully it's not in there, because if it is, then I'm like, oh, well, now I know why it sounds the way it sounds. Because from what I understand, they're not great. They're not great. They're great amps, but they're not great sounding, like, out of the box. So, you know, it takes a little doing to get them, you know, to get them going. And from what I understand, it might take a bit. But usually not something that will go more than a day of working out and stuff like that. I'm looking for my sponge. And I'm talking about maybe like 4 resistors and maybe 5 capacitors. You know, 2 main capacitors and a couple of other 2 main filter capacitors. And if you need to do something else, like if you have a lot of hum in your preamp section, chances are what it does is it takes AC off of the power trip. Excuse me, off of the power transformer. Meatloaf, off the power transformer, 6 volts, and it sends it to the filaments. So what you could do is you throw in another rectifier, and then you send it to a couple of more, what do you call those things? The freaking filter caps, filter capacitors, so that it smooths it out. So it smooths out the ripples, and then send that power to the filament, to the heaters.
I can't find it. Where be you?
A little bit sharp. I'm just realizing it's a little bit sharp. I usually don't freaking play up here, but. This one didn't. I lucked out. And I'm pretty sure it's been modded. I won't know until I open it up. Not getting my hands into it yet because I'm enjoying the living hell out of it. Which is saying something, considering. Because I'm usually... I can't leave things alone. And so for me to not touch something, you know, right away is definitely has, you know, gives something merit. So with that, you know, I mean, there's not really much more else to say except for, you know, if you find them out there and you don't mind freaking going after, I mean, and you don't mind, getting your fingers dirty and modding the goddamn thing to tweak it out, because from what I understand, the platform is fairly easy to work with. It's not like it's, you know, all messed up. It's a modern circuit. It's a, you know, It's not hand-to-hand point wiring and stuff like that. It is not surface mount, but it is PC board done. So, you know, I mean, if you can, if you feel so inclined, I say go for it. A lot of other people are like, don't touch it. But I feel if you're watching my channel, you have half a brain. So, perfect bedroom amp. does it compare to Shane's? Was it a Bugera? Bugera? Is it a Bugera that he got? I can't remember what the freaking one. It's not a Behringer, right? It's not a Behringer. It's a, I think it's a Bugera. And to his 5-watt amp, yeah, absolutely. It, I mean, the only difference is that his has hooked up to it a reverb, so it might have an extra tube in it, and his is a combo, so I mean, I'd imagine it depends. I can't remember what the hell Shane, if it was an 8-inch, was it an 8-inch? I think it was an 8-inch speaker he had in there. Now 8-inch speakers can be okay, they make great woofers if the cabinet is the right, if the cabinet is right, it'll have a nice response. But if not, and then the speaker has to have the correct amount of wattage in order, usually like a 25 watt will be sufficient enough to handle a 5-watt freaking amp. So if, you know, if all the components are freaking ripe for the picking, you'll have a nice sounding. You know? A nice setup. So, with that being said, I'm out of here. I've done my 15 minutes. I'm over, actually. Peace, y'all. Have a good one. And, be good.